foreign intervention commander, as you know, and rural that it has its historical roots in the pre-colonial phase. Since the time, not only peasantry but agricultural laborers and other artisans also have become strong, widespread indebtedness. Indebtedness can be associated with many problems such as poverty, high cost of production, low returns, unfavorable weather conditions, unproductive expenditure, etc. Almost every state has been suffering from this vice, which further causes economic as well as social distress among the rural households. The study focused on one of the important aspects of the loan is the purpose for which it is taken. This is because the loan taken and utilized for productive purposes such as capital and current expenditure in household enterprises can be expected to accelerate the economic activity of the households and ultimately promote their economic welfare. Hence, if a large number of households have taken loans for productive purposes, it is a sign of flourishing economic activity in the society. On the other hand, purposes like meeting household expenditure on litigation, repayment of debt, other financial investment expenditure, which we call non-economic income generating activities, may be considered as unproductive purposes, as the money spent on them neither result in production of goods and services nor bring any economic prosperity to the households. Such loan, if large or frequent, may lead to perpetual debt or misery. Therefore, the utilization pattern of the loan in which the amount of debt outstanding corresponding to the distribution as obtained from NSSO 2014 is presented in the present paper. In this perspective, the present paper is having following objectives. This is to examine the loan burden by source or on rural households in the state of Punjab. Second one is to find out the outstanding loan for farm and non-farm activities by rate of interest in Punjab, and to know about the cash loan outstanding to different sources according to the land holdings in Punjab. The methodology of the paper is based on the secondary data. The major source of data is the unit level record of the 70th round of NSSO 2014. The results and findings of the paper are, it has been found that out of the total amount of loan outstanding, 61% of the loan is outstanding against productive activities, and the remaining 39% of the loan is outstanding against unproductive activities. It has also been observed that the percentage of total amount of loan outstanding to the total amount of loan borrowed for different purposes from different credit institutions for all the households of rural Punjab has shown more than 100%. Utilization pattern by source of credit, then when we go through it, the utilization pattern along with the disbursement of loan and cash loan outstanding to the institutional and non-institutional credit over the purpose of loan as on 30th June 2012, it has been observed that 63% of the total loan is provided by institutional credit agencies and the remaining 37% of the loan is provided by non-institutional credit agencies. While in the case of cash loan outstanding, these proportions were found to 60% and 40% of the respective credit agencies. So it has been found that the formal credit agencies provide more proportion of loan for productive use and lesser for unproductive use. Contrary to this, informal credit agencies provide less proportion of loan for productive use and higher proportion of loan for unproductive use. When we go through source and utilization of credit according to the rate of interest, then it has been found that the institutional agencies have been found to play a significant role in providing credit to the households with moderate rate of interest. It has also been observed that the whole of the interest-free loan has been taken from the non-institutional agencies. It is due to the reason that the only source of these loans were relatives and friends. While analyzing the loan borrowed and loan outstanding for the year 2012, Similar trends could have been noticed regarding the purpose-wise and source-wise distribution of cash loan outstanding for different interest categories. Again, in case of loan outstanding, it has been observed that the proportion of loan outstanding known for institutional source has been higher than the non-institutional ones, up to 15% rate of interest, and for the rate of interest higher than 15%, the proportion of loan outstanding for non-institutional agencies turn out to be higher than the institutional agencies. So, with the objective of condensing the results and focusing on the major features, purpose relating to income generating activities and non-income generating activities, it has been observed that households of lower land holding groups incurred a relatively small part of real debt for productive purposes. Similar trends would have been noticed regarding the purpose-wise distribution of loan outstanding across different size of land holdings. It has been found that the households with large land holdings uses large amount of loan for productive purposes, and household with small land holding uses large number of loan for unproductive purposes. So at the end, it has been observed that the rural household indebtedness is somewhere related with the unproductive use of loan, which is responsible for the poor conditions of the cultivators and non-cultivators living in rural areas of Punjab. So along with curbing the exploitative mechanism of informal agencies, there is need to increase awareness among the rural households in general and agricultural households in particular about the disadvantages of utilization of loan in unproductive activities. Along with this, the economical benefits should be equally distributed among the disadvantages section of the societies. Thank you.
Thank you. So she presented her paper, which was largely focusing around the mechanism of credit delivery. So she mentioned that there is an informal credit delivery system prevailing in the rural Punjab, and it has many components which are affecting the loan takers. Interest is one, then land holding of the seeker is another one, and then his socio-economic conditions are another. She has made some suggestions how the system can be streamlined, how it can be a formal mechanism of credit delivery. And she also draw conclusion that it is the institutional credit which is mostly availed by people, and their rate of interest also suits them. And but again, as Dr. Grover has already mentioned, it is the easy availability of loans that attracts the seekers. So these are very useful information, useful conclusions which can be taken note of. Thank you very much. Now I would like the audience to ask some of the questions if they have some queries, some inputs they want to make in this paper. So everybody agrees with the presenter?
Same question.
If the paper is almost similar.
Same question I ask you. What are the requirements of the
farmer? The actions of financial institutional as well as non-institutional credit agencies. Institutional agencies provide more loan to the large farmers only because they have the security against the loan. But this, according to my study, small farmers have lesser access to the formal or we can say institutional credit. So I have suggested that there is a need to distribute the benefit, the economical benefits to the vulnerable section of the society who are not accessing in actual, who actually need more formal credit as compared to large farmers.
These are the small farmers. Recently, about this, I want to add this only.
Yes, definitely.